Let's give a giant Wisconsin welcome to the state representative from the 81st District, Madison's North Side, and other accompanying areas, Kelda Helen Roys.
If you're not on their email list, get on it right now at onewisconsinnow.org. My name is Kelda Helen Roys, and I have the privilege of being a state representative in this fine marble building. My privilege to be here is no greater than any of ours, because this is not my house, it's not the governor's house, it's not his mansion, and it's not the Koch brothers' house. It is. Was almost right. I did get denied, but it was actually five times I got denied coming in. Now, I want to say something about what's a pattern of undemocratic behavior. Today is not the first step in trampling on our democracy. We have seen day after day, as more and more people, hundreds of thousands of people, have struggled to make their voices heard, how desperate Walker and his Republican allies are at shutting us down and turning off democracy. We will not let them silence us. Even as they tried to do that, they turned off the legislative hotline. They shut down the legislative hearings. Assembly Democrats staffed those hearings around the clock 24 hours a day for a week to make sure that 5,000 people were able to testify, including a couple that were in favor of the bill. And that's what democracy is. We are going to listen to the people, all the people who want to be here peacefully. Well, that's why they turned off the legislative hotline, because they are not interested in listening to the voices of the people. Now Governor Walker is telling Democrats that he wants us to, quote, do our job. Now, apparently, in his private conversations, when he thinks he's talking to his GOP billionaire backers, he thinks that my job is to lay down and roll over for whatever he wants to do to take our state back. That's not my job. That's not my job, and that's not our job. My job is to stand up for what I believe is right, do what my constituents are asking me to do. And that's what our colleagues in the Senate are doing, the Democrats. They have given us. Very courageous, and every single day that we are out here, we give them strength and we help them. Every single day.
Yeah.
As this governor tries to make it harder on us and increases the adversity, the administration has locked down this building, and they have tried to put our law enforcement officers, who have partnered with us in over 2 weeks of peaceful protesting, including sleeping with us in solidarity on those marble columns. Us and our law enforcement officers. He is victimizing our law enforcement officers. It is outrageous. And you know what else? He's going to victimize them again once this budget comes out. I believe our governor intends to disband our excellent professional and privatize it.
Yeah.
To food and water in this building. He is trying to get them to shut us down and not allow us to have a public hearing. He tried to not let us reserve rooms in this building. Our house, not my house, our house. And time and time again, our partners in law enforcement have done everything they can to help us be peaceful and help enable our ability to petition our government, as we have the constitutional right to do. Yeah. And I bet there's actually some law enforcement officers here right now, plainclothes and first responders. Thank you. Now, we're not going to be silenced.
No. Hell no.
No matter what this governor does, no matter what he proposes, we are going to make sure that we are here, we are louder, we are more peaceful. We will not give him one excuse, not one, Not one excuse for this outrageous, undemocratic behavior, this attack on our democracy and our state.
Yes! Yeah.
Scott Walker and his Republican allies in the legislature, those Fitzgerald boys. They didn't let me vote on Friday morning. Now, our voices need to be heard, and they will be heard. But let me tell you what. Scott Walker is banking. He's banking on us falling apart, getting tired, shutting down. He's banking on us dividing. He's banking on us getting so angry and so tired and so beaten down that we start acting out and we start screaming at each other and screaming at the law enforcement officers. And kids here. We're peaceful. We're here with love in our hearts. We're here with smiles on our faces. We're here with joy in our spirits because we are here together for common purpose for the right cause. And no matter what happens in the coming days, the coming weeks, we are going to keep that joy. We are going to keep that peaceful spirit. We are going to make that commitment to ourselves and to each other. Give them even one excuse, not one excuse, to continue trampling on our democracy. And by that, day after day, we will win until the day we recall this guy and get him out of the Capitol for good.